Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Joe Broadway Road to the Show series here in MLB 14 The Show. Joe Broadway and the Arizona Diamondbacks are cruising through August. We're in the last week of August, taking on the San Diego Padres and then off to San Francisco to play the Giants. We'll jump right in here to the schedule in just a second. Joe Broadway is currently in the running for Rookie of the Year in the National League. We'll look at where that stands a little bit later in the video, but first we're going to head on out to Petco Park and check out this game action between the Arizona Diamondbacks and the San Diego Padres. You see, we're at 63-68, fighting to get back to that 500 mark. Broadway is going to lash one to left field there. Hit really hard. Shortstop dove but could not come up with it. That'll be a single for Mr. Broadway, and he's on first base. So he gets 12 points for that at bat. And we'll see a replay here because he hit this one pretty hard. He put a sting right on that, taking that out into left field. Nice effort by the shortstop, but not going to come up with it. So his next at bat here, or at least a later at bat in the seventh inning, and he's going to rocket this one in the left center. He's got a chance to get out of here, but oh, it's going to be caught right at the fence. Nope, couldn't quite get it out of Petco. Gave it a ride, but not enough. Let's see, that catch was made right out in front of the fence. So this game ends with Broadway getting just one hit and four at-bats, but it is also compounded by the fact that the Padres win the game 2-1, so nothing really went particularly well on this game. So we're going to go back out and see if we can make it even better here in the second game, try to get a win. First of all, this ball is slashed to right field and it's got a chance. It hits off the wall, and look at this. I kind of glitched out almost there. I was trying to get him to go to second base, honestly. He might have been a close play. They might have had a shot at throwing him out, but we'll never know because he stopped. And Kirk Gibson's like, face palm? Oh man. Why'd he stop at first base? They want to know. Yeah, kind of crazy play. I was jamming on that second base button, but it had nothing to do with it. You could almost see it like jerked him back towards first base. It was kind of like a odd, almost a glitch animation. Anyway, he comes back up and gets a single that actually looked like a single that time. And he gets an RBI in the play as well. So he gets two hits, knocks home a run in a 4-3 victory. So that's much better. That's what we're looking for. And again, we celebrate by sitting not on the bench, but inside the bench. Yes. So we split that series in San Diego, and it's time to go on out to San Francisco. Lovely, lovely AT&T Park. Love playing at this park. It is a beauty. Got the Cove out in right field. Yeah, it's a cool place. I hope to get there someday and see a game in person. So Joe Broadway's there in person in a 4-4 game in the third inning. Not much going on for pitching here. This ball's hit deep to right, and it's going to be caught right at the fence. Yeah. Didn't get on base there because he could not hit it quite far enough. Game will remain 4-4. It's 5-5 in the seventh now, and this ball is hit to center field. Will he have better luck there? Oh, yeah, it's out of here. It is a Broadway bomb. So I guess the key is to go to center field, not to right field, and maybe wait till it gets dark and this ball carries out better. I don't know. He hit this ball real well. So he works a four-pitch at bat, hits the solo homer, and gets a ton of points for himself. We need to get another look at this one. Let's see here. He hits the straightaway center field, and he tagged it. Let's see, 400-something, I'm sure. Let's see the footage. Oh, we're not going to get the footage? Had to have been 420 feet, I would imagine, to hit it out there. So the Diamondbacks win 7-6. Okay, so they're stringing a few wins together. Maybe we can make that run towards 500 and beyond. What are we at right now? 66-69. Broadway hits his 19th home run of the season. 19 Broadway bombs for the rookie Joe Broadway. Going to be hitting fifth in the lineup here. And this is what I was talking about, checking out the Rookie of the Year standings. He is currently in second in the running for that behind Stephen Houston. So we'll continue to track that. But we're going to go back on out to AT&T Park and try to get another victory. So it's scoreless in the second inning. Broadway's at the plate. And he is going to hit this to left center, and it's going to find the gap. Going to the wall, he should easily have second base if he doesn't stop at first this time, and he doesn't. And he's standing up at second with that double. Good job by Broadway right there. And he gets 20 points there, working a five-pitch at bat, and then getting that extra base hit. Let's see the replay. He pulled this into the left center field gap. Make those outfielders run for a while, chasing that down. And he easily coasts into second base. So while he's out there, one out and a 1-1 count, and that's going to be fair down the first base line. Right fielder is charging and throwing, but Broadway's going to test him, and that throw is way offline. He scores the run easily from second base, and there is the Diamondbacks coming through once again. 4-0 ball game in the fifth. Broadway up again, and he lashes this out to left field. He gets down for a hit. Runner coming around third, and he will score. That's cut off, and another run comes home. It's an RBI for Broadway, and another solid at-bat. So he gets a multiple hit game once again against the Giants, and they win again, 5-1. I believe that's four straight wins for the Diamondbacks now. That is something to build around. Definitely got to keep that momentum going. And we look at another opportunity against the Giants to be in the lineup for Broadway. And he hopes to make the most of it. We're just two games under 500 now. And we're just about even with the Giants record on the season. So Broadway hitting 340 right now. You see 3-for-9 with the homer in this series. Looking to tack onto that and see what else he can do. Diamondbacks already up 1-0 in the first. This ball is hit to right center field, and it is going to get over his head. Oh, it's going to go to the wall. I thought maybe he'd make the catch, but no. Look at these runners hustling. One behind the other coming to the plate, and they're not going to throw home for either one of them. It's a two RBI double for Joe Broadway. All right. Let's see what happened out there when we get to the replay. I don't know if he just couldn't catch up to it or what. So Broadway puts a charge into this. Opposite field, yeah, I don't know. If that was in the sun, it looked like Hunter Pence just kind of screwed up out there a little bit. But it goes as a double and two RBI for Joe Broadway. So he comes back up later on in the game and looking to get a multiple hit game once again. Sixth inning, 4-1. And is that fair? Slicing? No, it stayed fair down the line. Nice play right there. And, okay, we saw this earlier where he stopped at first. He says, nah, forget that. Despite some hesitation, he gets to second base. Looks like the Diamondbacks might be rolling to yet another victory the way things are going today. We're going to look at a replay of what just happened. And this hit is going to bring another run home. How close was it? Oh, yeah, it was like right on the chalk. Almost hits the guys out in the bullpen out there. And he saw it was kind of hard to handle out there for Hunter Pence or whoever that was out in right field. So it's a 5-1 Diamondbacks victory. And they get to celebrate once again. That's five in a row, I believe. And no surprise that in those five games they've won in a row, it's a five-game hitting streak for Joe Broadway as well. So we're moving on into the San Diego series. We'll get into the second game of it. And we won yet again. Look at this. We're now 69-69. We hit that 500 mark. And look at how we are tied with not only the Giants, but the Padres as well. All of us 69-69 and 7.5 games back.
And welcome back to the MLB pregame show as we prepare you for game two of our series with the always important Topps Player Spotlight. Joe Broadway is our focus. And the rest of the baseball world is buzzing about him as well. He's one of the best up-and-coming talents in the big leagues, and he's playing very well right now.
Yeah, we're going to be talking about him for a long time to come, Matty. He's still very young, and, you know, his performance lately has been far better than anyone would have expected out of him. But going into this season, many people kind of saw him as a rising superstar, but based on the numbers he's putting up, he's kind of already there. I'm sure eventually he'll run into some rough patches at some point in his development, but right now, he's playing like an all-star.
Okay, we're looking forward to this one. Lineups and first pitch on the show coming up next.
So there we have another monthly recap for Joe Broadway. Things going well in August, but we are now into September and looking to finish the season strong. We're wearing throwbacks today against the Padres, and they're wearing their throwbacks as well. And that is a ground out to Broadway, thrown over to first, getting the easy play. I guess his reaction could have been better because he doesn't get the full 7 or 8 points. But he's got that five-game hitting streak going, and he's hoping to continue it today. It's 5-2 Arizona already in the third, and base hit up the middle. Pitcher couldn't get it and can't stop it from going out to center field for a base hit. So it's now a six-game hitting streak. But what they're more importantly worried about is keeping the winning streak going. And it looks like the team effort to do that so far, so good. 7-3 when this ball's hit the right center field. And it's going to get over the wall. It was a line drive shot. But it is indeed a Broadway bomb. It was a line drive, rocket shot to get out of here right away. And it is a very big one because that is his 20th on the season. He hits the milestone, 20 homers. Joe Broadway just clubbed it out of the park, and we are going to see it again. Goes to right center field, 385 feet, just to the right of the pool area. One of these days, he's going to hit a splashdown pool home run, but today is not the day. He was much closer in the last episode. So the Diamondbacks win again, 8-4, and they keep that winning streak going. Thanks in part to our buddy Joe Broadway, who is named the player of the game, and we get to see the highlight package here brought to us by Topps. And frankly, Joe Broadway deserved this player of the game for going deep, hitting the home run, and having two hits on the ball game while wearing throwback uniforms. Yeah, gotta love those throwbacks. So, that's another win. What are we up to now? I'll have to look at the calendar. I think it's been 7 or 8 in a row that we've won now. And hopefully we can continue that. So 4 at-bats, he gets 2 hits, one of those being a big home run. And it was that milestone 20th for the season. So I think that big milestone shot probably puts him on the top of the list for Rookie of the Year in the National League right now. That's where we're going to end off, as we are hot on this streak, both for a hitting streak for Broadway and a winning streak for the Diamondbacks. We'll see you next time as we take on the Padres again.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.